I'm Pastor Mark Buto, and this is another Higher Things video short. Cain and Abel. The first brothers, the first murder, the first religions. So that's a lot to talk about in one story, the story of Cain and Abel. The first brothers, the first murder, the first religions. So Eve and Adam, after they are expelled from the garden because of their sin, have their first son. They fulfill the Lord's command to be fruitful and multiply. And the first son born is Cain. And when he is born, Eve says, "I have gotten a man, the Lord." She thinks that her baby born is the Lord. Now, it's not. It's just Cain. But what that shows us is that Eve and Adam understood what God's promise was. They understood that at some point, a child born of a woman would be the Savior. It wasn't to be yet, but it reminds us that Adam and Eve are looking forward to the fulfillment of that promise of a Savior coming, Savior being sent by the Lord to rescue them from their sin, to crush the devil's head. Well, Cain grows up and he's going to be a farmer. Abel, his brother, grows up and he's going to be a shepherd. Now, they both bring their offerings to the Lord. Abel brings a sheep and offers it up, kills the sheep, burns the sheep on the altar, and Cain brings some of the fruit of the ground, some veggies or whatever he's got, some things that he's grown. And the Bible says the Lord respected and received Abel's offering, but not Cain's, and Cain got mad. Now, what's going on there? Was Abel a better person? Did he offer better things because he took the first fruits of his flock, whereas Cain maybe just brought some leftovers or something like that? Okay, this is not simply a sermon on good or bad stewardship and people putting something in the plate, whether it's their leftovers or their first fruits. What's going on here, and we learn this not only from what we see in the book of Genesis, this is chapter 4, by the way, but also because of the book of Hebrews, which tells us that Abel was a preacher of righteousness. In other words, Abel believed that by the sacrifice of that lamb, his sins were forgiven. Not because he sacrificed the lamb, but because God had promised that in exchange for that lamb's life, he would take away Abel's sins. Cain, on the other hand, thought by just showing up and throwing some stuff on the altar, he was doing God a favor. He was showing the Lord how godly he was, how much religion he had. And this is where the two religions begin. Abel's religion was the religion of the promise that looked forward to the coming of the Savior, the promise that says that by God's grace, Abel's sins were forgiven. That's because of Jesus, way, way down the road. That's shown to us by the lamb that Abel offers. But Cain thought his religion was about showing God something, doing something for God, earning his own righteousness. And God doesn't receive that. He rejects it because he says, that's not how my people will live. They'll live by my promises, not by what they do for me. They'll live by what I do for them. So Abel lives by the promise and Cain lives by his own works. And when that doesn't work out so well, and when he realizes that religion is false, and when the Lord tells him, probably through his father Adam, that that's no acceptable religion because he's trying to live for himself and for God rather than seeing what God's doing for him and his promise, Cain gets mad. And so he persecutes Abel. In fact, he persecutes him all the way until death. He kills Abel while he's out in the field. And this really is the beginning of two religions. The religion of those who trust the Lord's promises and have nothing for themselves, but only to rely upon what the Lord promises to give them in his grace and mercy. And those who want to live for God and do for God and show how holy they are and how much godliness they've got and how much religion they've got. And they'll take out even their opposition if they think that those who live by the promises, well, that's a silly religion, and so they'll get rid of them. And so it's always been that those who think they've got themselves squared away with God persecute those who trust in God's promises. We've seen it throughout history. Religions based on the law, based upon what people do, based upon what they offer God, based upon how holy they are, they persecute those who live by grace. Well, Cain gets banished for this sin, and yet the Lord still, in his grace, preserves Cain and puts a mark upon him and says, if anyone kills Cain, then I'll kill them. And Cain then goes off and lives his own life, and he marries a couple women, has a couple wives, and decides that if anyone kills him, because he killed some guys, that they're gonna pay. And so Cain starts to make in his own religion, his own law and his own word. Instead of saying what God promises, Cain makes Cain's own promises. And off it goes. Well, now that Abel's dead, Adam and Eve have other children. Of course, they had tons of children, many that we don't even know about because they lived like 900 years as they were fruitful and populated the earth. But the next child that we hear about is Seth. And it is through Seth that the line is carried. The promise is passed down. You can see that in Genesis chapter 5, where we have the genealogies that go from Adam down to Noah. And then so there's the story of Cain and Abel. The first murder, the first two religions, the religion of grace, the religion of works, and the beginning of the story of sin working its way out, seeing murders and hatred and all those sorts of things. And that's what the fall has brought into the world. Yet the Lord is faithful in his promise to bring a Savior someday. And that promise goes down then through the line of Seth, as we'll see. And next time then, talk about Noah and the flood. I'm Pastor Mark Buto. This has been another Higher Things video short.